Hello. We're in Thailand, Chiang Mai. This is actually our apartment, right back there. We're going to get some lunch before we go into the afternoon training. It's kind of funny because we get up at 6, go running at 6:30, train until 10, go eat breakfast, and then about an hour and a half later we eat lunch. So it's, I don't know, kind of an interesting schedule that I've never really had before, but I definitely need the calories, so doing it that way is actually kind of nice. That getting hungry an hour later thing is awesome. And it's not the food, actually. The food is very filling, so it's a combination of a lot of work and wanting to eat the food because it's really good. On the way to breakfast this morning, we stopped at this little vendor stand and got some fresh fruit, like in a bag. Everything comes in a bag here. And it was delicious. You can actually see it right here. We're coming up on it. That's the stand up there. We got some pineapple in a bag with like sugar and chili that you like dip in there. And then watermelon. It's absolutely amazing that we're eating watermelon and pineapple in January and it tastes that good. It's really cool. Training is going really well. I can't believe it's only the second day of full training. And even at that, I haven't done the second session yet. Feels like we've been here for like weeks. Andy told me that I need to kind of, you know, ease into it, take it down a little bit, make sure that I'm not burning myself out. So I'm definitely trying to like pay attention to when I need to rest and not burn myself out in each session each day. Knowing that I have a PM session, I'm kind of more willing to burn myself out in the afternoon rather than in the morning. But it's also partially that I'm trying to like show rest and responsibility as a way of showing him that I am listening to him, that I can be taught. But at the same time, I don't think he knows how hard I train. So it's kind of a balancing thing of training as hard as I want to and I need to, but also listening to what my body can do and you know, kind of what I'm doing. But things are good. I was doing some pad work with a kid in the ring today. He's probably like 14 years old. He's my size. And yesterday he was laughing at me every time he punched me in the stomach, which is not the worst thing. It was a little bit stunning. I had kind of a weird reaction to it. I knew he wasn't laughing at me, but it kind of feels weird to have someone laugh when they hit you. But today I just started laughing too every time he hit me, and I felt really good and started asking him about techniques, and he really helped me out a lot. He came out of the ring with me and showed me some stuff doing knees on the pads or on the bag, and that was really good. So I'm excited. I like the idea of my kind of rest, because I'm going to be kind of resting a little more than I was. My rest is getting technique, which is really good. These are the dogs from the gym. Is this the one you like or the other one?
Yeah.
That's a mama dog.
Yeah.
That's mama dog. Hey, honey. All right. Gotta go get some food.
I think that's the one I like. I'm not sure. I thought the one I like had bigger ears.